Oh, yes, it's on. Tonight, 7:30 on SABC3, it's Tropica Island of Treasure Curacao. Got me all so excited. Now, with most of you baking your way through lockdown, let's talk about baking. We hope that these crushed fruity scones that we're about to make it to your baking repertoire because they are so impressive. Packed with vitamins A, C, and E, Krush has a range of 100% fruit juice flavors your family will enjoy, with pure goodness in every glass and pure goodness in every taste. Indeed, a perfect pairing to this tasty treat that we're about to make. Nicole Snelling, when you said scones, I said, say no more. I am coming to your high tea, lady.
Thank you. Well, welcome to the high tea. I'm about to make you some upgraded scones.
Thanks so much for that.
So let's first get our fruit, what are you, rehydrated. Okay. So these are dried fruit. We've got apricots and dried cranberries.
Great.
So what you do is you put 4 tablespoons, the recipe calls for to put in the microwave, but we're gonna do it obviously on the stove here.
So it's nice to know that you can do it on the microwave or in the microwave as well as on the stove itself. A lot of people that I know certainly did go out and buy lots of dried fruit when they heard about the lockdown. The panic buyers,
Shame on you.
But now you are at home stuck with all these dried fruit because you realize you actually can go to the shop and buy essential goods. You don't need to have or 12.5 kgs of dried fruit.
But that's where we come in.
Now you can use them.
So you can use any dried fruit that you have. You could use raisins. I'm sure a lot of people have that. You can even add nuts in here as well if you want to. But any good scone starts with butter and flour. Okay. So we've added that in, a little bit of sugar for the sweetness.
Yes.
A little bit of baking powder, that's your rising agent.
Baking powder. All right, some salt there as well. What does the salt then do with all that combination? Is it to neutralize the reaction?
It brings out flavor.
It brings out the flavor.
Okay, otherwise, you're going to have very bland flour tasting scones, and you don't want that.
Nobody wants that.
So this is where you get your fingers involved. This is also a great way to get the kids involved as well, because it's super fun. I mean, I love it. It's so therapeutic. So you just rub the flour and the butter together, because that's almost your shortening method. That's what you want. You want beautiful flaky scones, and this is how you achieve it.
Oh, is that where the flakiness of it all comes from?
Rubbing in your butter.
Nothing is ever coincidental when it comes to scones, it seems like, or when it comes to anything baked.
No, it's a science. It really is a science. That's why when you bake, just make sure you do it properly, because you have so much effort. You've got ingredients that you don't want to go to waste. You've got your butter, you've got your fruit, this beautiful fruit juice. You don't want any of it to go to waste, so just do it properly. Follow the recipe.
I have to tell you, this is the first time that I have seen fruit juice being brought into the mix of anything baked, so this is quite interesting. And I think it's going to inspire a lot of people out there, because the thing is, on social media, everywhere you turn, people are baking something
so
every day.
Banana bread especially.
Banana bread has become so popular, and it's so good to see. People are doing very interesting things, but also they are looking at ways to elevate it and make it interesting and new and fresh and exciting for their family.
So I'm just straining the juice there, just because you can always add more rather than having to add flour. So we're going to throw
better
in your...
to have more.
No, less is more, and you can always add more. So like my consumers teacher in high school taught me, when you're making scones, we were never allowed to use a spoon, always a knife, because you've got to cut it. So you don't want to, you're cutting it because you're shortening the flour. It's a very pastry term. So if you mix it too much, you're working the gluten, you're going to land up with chewy buns, almost like a roll rather than a scone.
Yeah, well, class is in session, and I hope you've got your notepads out. Shortening the flour, that's the term for the day. Shortening the flour, which means what again, Nicole?
Shortening the flour.
You said you're shortening.
Make it flaky.
Make it flaky.
And
that's
you don't stretch the gluten in the flour.
We are in the process of assembling a whole baking dictionary, myself and Nicole here.
You better be taking notes.
By the time the lockdown's over, I promise you, we're going to have a whole A4 page with all the terminology that you use
A4,
in baking.
We want a book. We got to train you well, Sabiso.
Okay, Nicole, let's take it easy. Let's take it easy. It's our first time, okay? Okay, cool.
So as you can see, it comes together very beautifully. At this point, you can see you don't need to add any more liquid. So if I added all of this, it would have been too wet.
It's good that you put it on the side.
Exactly.
Okay, cool. So what do you do after this?
Just flour your surface, because you don't want it to stick.
Yes.
You're going to take your beautiful scone mixture.
Flouring the surface. Flouring the surface. That means placing
Flour on your surface.
Flour on the surface. so that your whatever mixture you've made doesn't stick onto the surface.
Exactly.
Flouring the surface.
So using a cookie cutter, if you don't have one, use a glass. Like, as you can see there, I've just put flour over it so that it doesn't stick when you cut it out.
Cookie cutting. Cookie cutting means no need for that.
So this is all that you do. Cut it out, pop it onto a baking sheet on a preheated of 190.
All right, 190 is usually 180. Why is it 190 this time?
Because you want a little bit of a higher heat because they are smallish scones. So you don't want them to go for too long, otherwise you are going to dry them out. And that's why the higher heat helps them.
The fruit adds so much character to the scones.
Definitely.
You don't see this often. But I think the taste of the juice coming in there as well is going to make it such a unique taste.
The juice is infused into the fruit. That's why you rehydrate it with the fruit juice.
Okay.
Which people usually do water. Why do water when you can have orange juice?
Hello.
Right.
Well, our recipe today was inspired by the scone recipes that have been shared during our Clover competition. We've received so many. We are so inspired by the amazing work that you guys are doing at home. One of our top fans, Radhika Hansraj, says that the secret to her scones is using Clover sour cream and Clover Mama Bake. That Mama Bake. Inez Maybach says, also earned her baking stripes by sharing a picture of her delicious Malva pudding, which she serves with Clover Classic Custard. We love it. Looks so good. Look
so
at that.
Good.
So yummy. There simply is no better combination. We love that. Inez, and of course, the question to all of you now is, have you entered? Simply reply to the Clover competition post on our Facebook page, Espresso Morning Show SABC3, or our Twitter page by posting a picture of your recipe creation. Use the hashtag #LoveClover and tell us which Clover product you used to create your dish. There will be one winner every week until the 29th of May. You've still got some time. We're going to be looking at the most creative recipe using a Clover product, any Clover product. And the winner will win a Clover Love Pack hamper and will be making that recipe right here on the show. So it's an opportunity for your recipe to shine. So get your pots ready and enter T's and C's. You can find them on espressoshow.com. And now it's about taste.
Yes, please don't let all my hard work and baking go to waste.
Taste. Do you know what taste means? Taste is when Tabiso opens his mouth, takes the goodie that's finished.
And tell me it's great.
And gives feedback. Oh, yes.
Good.
Oh, yes. It is so magnifique. 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 Magnifique.
Good.
I love it.
Thank you.
Yes.
Clover Krush. 100% pure fruit juice packed with vitamins and no added sugar. Krush, your daily goodness. Now also available in Long Life.
Made with love by Clover.